This is the Cavern Penetration Training Dive in my 4-dive series on rack and cavern penetration. Before we get into the cavern, we tie on securely. This way, we've always got a safe route out. Got to remember our cookies. Good thing we're underwater. There's not much headroom here. We want to tie off often. And this is asking Max to come back and use this rock as a tie off. Yep, easy to miss. Got to add our direction arrows, so we know the way out. Hey, look at how the bubbles flow over the ceiling, just like how mercury would flow over rocks. Everything takes longer when we're underwater. Got to add our direction arrows so we know the way out.
I don't know. pocket.
Got to add our direction arrows so we know the way out. Yuri's asking me for a pair of direction arrows. If you take a look here, we've got one direction arrow pointing the way that we came from, a cookie, and then a direction arrow point. This would normally be added only after the line had been fully laid and somebody had come back knowing where the center point was. We then have one direction to get out on one end and one direction to get out on the other end. All of the arrows point the shortest path to an exit. It may not be the most desirable, but when you're low on air, any exit is the most desirable. This site is quite popular, as you see with other divers swimming through. It seems there's too much choice here. Which rock to tie onto? Got to add our direction arrows so we know the way out. Okay. Wouldn't that one be better on the other side? Got to add our direction arrows so we know the way out. I think that would be more secure over the larger section of rock. And around again. Got to add our direction arrows so we know the way out. got to add our direction arrows, so we know the way out. End of the line. Oh, stop. It's that time again! Nope, not last line. This is bailout! And see if your buddy can get you out of there. I'm leading this time. I would play the Mission Impossible theme tune here. However, I'm quite sure that one's copyrighted. So you'll just have to sing it to yourselves. As we're passing each obstruction, I'm grabbing Max's hand and moving it from the previous section of line to the next section of line. That way he's not having to feel around, and he's not being dragged too much by me. Thank you. Yay, we made it out. That wasn't too hard, right? Last line time. Max first. Remember I said this site was popular? This is a different lot of swim-throughs. Lost line time. My turn. First, trying to find somewhere to anchor my safety line to. Found something. It's about as thick as two fingers and about half the length. If I wrap my safety line around it enough, it'll be secure. I'm also thinking about the shape of the cave. I know it's got a oval top to it. It's quite flattened. It goes from shallow at the edges to a lot higher in the middle. So I know which way the line is probably. I'm actually thinking that I'm about a meter, maybe two, closer to the entrance and on the other side of the cave. But hey. I was laughing because of how close to the halfway point I clipped onto. Hey, a couple of centimetres the other way, well, 20 centimetres the other way, and I would have gone to the other exit. time to pack up. We're done for this one.